Hi, it's Mitch from PickDogs.com here with your free pick in the Marlins versus Cardinals Major League Baseball matchup on Monday, April 5th, 2021. The Marlins, well, off to a little bit of a slow start, taking on the Tampa Bay Rays. Of course, the Rays went to the World Series last year out of the American League, and I know they lost Blake Snell, but doesn't mean that they are not a good team. I mean, that organization just always seems to win. So it was a series of tight games with the Marlins and Rays, and all three of the games in that series could have gone either way. Two of them went the Rays' way, and one went the Marlins' way, but one of them was a blown lead late. The one was extra innings, and the other one was a tight Marlins win. So certainly nothing to hang their head on, and you know, with the expectations somewhat muted for the Marlins as usual, well, they certainly exceeded expectations, I would say, in that series. Meanwhile, for the Cardinals, you know, the addition of Nolan Arenado didn't pay any dividends yet. 1-2 in those games in Cincinnati. They jumped on the Reds in game one and something fierce. You know, 5 runs in the first inning of the first game this season. But after that, you know, really not overly impressive. It was the Reds doing a lot of the jumping. And I think when we look at the Cardinals, it's easy to identify what the issue is there and easy to identify that we might have some opportunities down the road on these St. Louis Cardinals. And of course, the issue is that their number two and number three pitchers are both out. So that means the entire rotation has to move up. So their number one won, right, in Flaherty. But you know, he's not a great number one, but he got the win in game one because the offense came out and beat up on Castillo. But the thing is, Wainwright, who was 4 in the rotation, had to pitch in the number two spot. They lost to the Reds in that game. And then on Sunday, they had to start Carlos Martinez, who was 5 or maybe not even in the rotation at all. And he, you know, he did what Carlos does, you know, lost. And you know, it got to the bullpens, though. You know, it was pretty low scoring early in the game. The thing is that with Arenado and Goldschmidt and, you know, the rest of the cast of characters that the Cardinals have, we know that they're going to be good. It's just a matter of time, and can they do it with the, you know, Daniel Ponce de Leon, who gets the start here. You know, when Ponce de Leon came onto the scene in the American in the major leagues, he was lights out. He threw basically a no-hitter his first time pitching. I believe he ended up giving a hit up late in that game. I think it was like, you know, 26 straight batters or something he put down. And it was the last guy up that got a hit. It was something like that, like a no-hitter that, you know, that disintegrated late. But, you know, he has all of the tools, you know, because we've seen him do it. But, you know, since that game, you know, the Cardinals handled him like very gently. And then, you know, he never really has developed into that frontline pitcher that we thought he was going to be after that game. It's, you know, he went had a 2.73 ERA in 2018 and 3.70, 4.96. So you get the picture. He's going in the wrong direction. And then it's happening early in his career, not something that we see from Cardinals pitching. Meanwhile, on the other side of this one, Trevor Rogers for the Marlins. This guy, he has been light on appearances. We saw him mostly in relief last season. He does have a couple starts under his belt. But one thing about this guy, okay, this guy strikes out hitters like no one's business. Yeah, he gives up hits and he gives up home runs and he does all those things that we don't like when we bet on pitchers, right? And, you know, especially if we have an under in there cooked in. But, you know, 28 innings pitched, 32 hits allowed, and 20 runs over that span, 19 of them earned with 13 walks. But listen to this, 39 strikeouts in 28 innings. All he's got to do is work on that control, not get let those walks in. And, you know, how many of those scored? You know, 5 home runs over that 28 innings. A guy like this, something like 29 strikeouts, you can't, or 39 strikeouts in 28 innings, you can't teach that. This guy just has a gift, and I'll tell you what, if they can get him right, he is going to be an elite pitcher in Major League Baseball. First-round pick, 13th overall by the Marlins, so not a surprise, not a mystery, none of those things. And I'll tell you what, it's going to win this game, too. I'm going to take the Marlins here, minus 110. That's going to be my free pick. Let me know what you think of this game, and by all means, put your pick in the comment of this video. And while you're there, if you can hit the thumbs up, that is greatly appreciated. If you're looking for some premium picks, just click on the link in the description of this video and find out how you can get our YouTube premium picks. You get a pick each from myself, Rod Zawiecki, and Brian Bittler of our premium picks that we do on the website, or other picks that, you know, that where lines change, something of that nature, which are games that we're betting today. You can find those in our YouTube premium picks. It's an inexpensive way to get started on finding out what our premium picks are all about.